Hello everyone, today we are going to start a new topic, that is natural, damped and forced vibrations. So you all know that sound is a form of energy and it comes from vibrations, and all sounds are made by vibration of molecules through which the sound travels. So here we are going to discuss the kinds of vibrations, and basically the three kinds of vibration, that is natural, damped and forced vibrations. So you must have observed this case which I am showing here, that is a monkey shaking the branch of a tree, or you can say swinging on this branch of a tree, and due to which the branch of the tree is vibrating, is it? Because we are going to study about the kind of vibration, so I have taken this example so that you can understand this topic very easily. So when you see this, when the monkey used to vibrate, means when they used to swing on the branch of the tree or used to shake the branch of the tree, there is a vibration produced in the branch of the tree. So what my question is, when they jump from one branch to the other branch, like this monkey, if leave this branch and jump on some other branch of the tree, so in that case, will the vibration of the branch of the tree will continue or it will stop? What do you think? So the answer is, after some time it will stop. What if it continues forever? So if the branch of the tree will continue to vibrate forever, so that case will be the case of free vibration. And if the branch of the tree will stop vibrating after some time, so that will become a case of damped vibration. So actually, in actual case, what we'll see is that the branch of the tree will stop vibrating after some time when the monkey will jump from this branch. Is it? And why it will stop? So we all know that around the tree, everywhere atmosphere is there. Atmosphere is there, that means air is present. Air is present, that means air molecules are present, which will apply a resistive force on this branch, and due to which the vibration of the branch of the tree will stop after some time. That is the case, is it? So this is why I have taken this example, so that you can understand. So if suppose the air is not present, suppose everywhere there is a vacuum around the tree, there is only vacuum, no air present, no air molecules are there. That means no resistive force is there. So that means no opposing force is present, and due to which the vibration will continue. So such kind of vibration, in which the vibration will continue forever and there is no opposing force to stop the vibration of the body, that kind of vibration is your free vibration. So all kind of vibration which we'll discuss will happen actually in atmosphere. That means it all the cases which we'll see examples in day-to-day life, vibration of the bodies, they all take place in the presence of air, is it? So if all these process takes place in the presence of vacuum, so that will come in the category of free vibration. But free vibration is only an ideal case, not an actual case. Actually, all the cases are of damped vibration. Clear? So natural vibration, or you can say free vibration, occurs only in vacuum. And the example that you can see is the case of vibration in which air is present. Therefore, this is an example of damped vibration. Clear? Now, how we can define natural vibrations? So the periodic vibrations of a body means when a body repeats its motion continuously on a definite path in a definite interval of time. So that motion is called your periodic motion, and the interval of time, that time interval, is called the time period. Clear? And vibratory motion, also known as oscillatory motion. So when the body in periodic motion moves to and fro about a definite point, means like a oscillation of a bob, simple pendulum. The bob of a simple pendulum oscillates to and fro. So that motion is your oscillatory motion, also known as vibratory motion. Clear? So natural vibration is the periodic vibration of a body in the absence of any external force on it are called the natural or free vibrations. Now there are few points that you have to learn is that when a body clamped at one point and when disturbed slightly from its rest position, so it will start vibrating, is it? So the vibration so produced, they are called natural or free vibration if it is in vacuum. Remember, all that case natural vibration will discuss, that will be in vacuum. So the period of vibration depends, this period of vibration depends on the shape and size or the structure of the body. This is the first point. Second, the time period of the body is called its natural period and the frequency is called its natural frequency. Third point, a body capable of vibrating has a constant natural frequency of its vibrations and its amplitude of vibrations remains constant. That means any body which is capable of vibrating has a constant natural frequency. Even we, if we'll consider about human being, we also have a natural frequency, okay, because we are able to produce vibration, is it? So everybody which is capable of vibrating has a constant natural frequency of its vibration, and in this case amplitude of vibrations remains constant. And the last important point is that such kind of vibrations occurs only in vacuum, because if air is present, any external force, resistive force is present, then it will stop the vibration of the body. Then that will not be the case of natural vibrations. Natural vibrations occurs only in vacuum. So as I told you that this case of natural vibration occurs in vacuum and the amplitude of vibration remains constant because the vibration continues forever. So the amplitude also remains same and the frequency also remains the same. So this is the displacement time graph for natural or free vibration, which is a completely ideal case. As I told you, in actual this kind of displacement time graph will not get, means this is case for natural vibration in vacuum. So in vacuum we'll consider that the amplitude will remain constant, then in this case frequency will remain constant. So that is why you can see this time, this type of graph in which the throughout with time the amplitude remains constant, is it? So this is a graph for displacement time graph for natural or free vibration. Now coming to the examples. So there are tons of examples for natural or free vibrations, but few I have selected for you. So first is the case of the bob of a simple pendulum which is oscillating, as you can see. So the question is again here that if you have seen in our lab also, the pendulum is there. So if we suspend a bob through a thread and we take the bob to a extreme position and we leave it, so it will start to and fro motion, as you can see in the figure. So will the vibration, will this motion will stop or it will continue? So again my answer is, if it is in air, so it will definitely will stop. But if we'll consider this in vacuum, if the bob is oscillating in vacuum, so in that case this example will be the example for free vibration. Clear? Now you all know the mean and extreme position for a bob of a simple pendulum, is it? So this to and fro motion of the bob, this will be the mean position and this will be the extreme position, and here also this will be the extreme position, is it? So in this case, if the bob is oscillating freely in vacuum with its natural frequency, as we have seen that everybody has its own natural frequency, so this bob of a simple pendulum also will have its own natural frequency, and this frequency is given by the formula F is equal to 1 upon 2 by under root G by L, where L is the length of this thread through which this bob is suspended. Okay, so this is the formula for finding out the frequency. Here you can say that 2 pi is a constant and g, which is acceleration due to gravity, so it is also a constant, 9.8 meter per second square. So what you can say that frequency depends on length and it is inversely proportional to length. So different pendulum having different length will vibrate with different frequencies, is it? Now the second case you can see is a load suspended from a spring. When stressed or compressed and then it is released, like you stretch this and then you release it. So again you can see here the vibration. So if this is occurring in vacuum, then this will become example of damped vibration, but it means free vibration. But in real case, this is an example for damped vibration because it is not in vacuum. So if you can see this example, this is an example for natural vibration if it is occurring in vacuum. If it is occurring in the air present, then this is an example for damped vibration. Now in this case also, the frequency is given by f is equal to 1 by 2 L under root k by m, where k is a constant which is known as force constant. Clear? Now the frequency is determined by the hardness of the spring and the mass of the load suspended. Clear? So in this case the frequency will be different for the same load. Because if you can see that f is equal to 1 by 2 L under root k by m. So frequency is depending on, it is inversely proportional to mass, is it? So we can say that the frequency will be different for the same load on different springs. Also, it will be different for different loads on the same spring. Are you getting? That means if we have two springs and same load is suspended, so the frequency will be different for both. And suppose if we have this spring only and we are suspending two different masses on it, then in that case also we have the different frequencies. Clear? So this is one more example for the natural or free vibration. Now third is the case of a flute. So all of you have seen the flute, or I hope all of you have tried. So in this case, in the flute you can see there are holes present, is it? So when an air column in a flute or organ pipe is also kind of musical instrument, through which by giving the air pressure, vibrations are produced and musical sounds are, we can hear the musical sounds from it. So when an air column in a flute is made to vibrate, it vibrates with its natural frequency, and in this case this frequency is proportional to the length of the air column. So when they used to play on the flute, so they, if you have seen that, they used to change their fingers on this hole. They keep the fingers, their fingers on this holes, and they used to keep on changing. So that means they keep on changing the length, is it? So because they will change the length, the frequency will also change, because frequency in the case of a flute is inversely proportional to the length. Now by changing the effective length, they will change the different frequencies. So we'll listen the different kind of sound producing by the flute. Otherwise, if they will keep all the fingers, so only, or not change the finger on the different holes of the flute, so we'll listen only one kind of sound from the flute. Clear? Now if we'll consider about an organ pipe. So organ pipe are of two types, one which is open at one end and close at other end, and second which are open at both ends. So all that you have to study in class 11, so we'll not go in that detail here. We are considering only the example. So if we'll consider the organ pipe of given length, which is open at both ends, so in that case different modes of vibrations are produced by blowing the air by blowing the air differently, and they are in the frequency, they are of the frequency in the ratio 1 is to 3 is to 4 like that. While if we'll consider the other case, the organ pipe with one closed end and the one is open, so in that case the frequencies of different modes, they are in the ratio 1 is to 3 is to 5. So this what I am saying is all that you have to study in class 11th. Here just for your exam, this is the case, we are considering only the examples of natural vibrations. So just keep in mind that in the case of a flute here, the frequency is inversely proportional to the length, and by changing the effective length, the frequency will change for a flute. Now next example is the example of a, if you see the string instruments, like we have sitar, then we have sonometer, then we have violin, there are many instruments, string instruments. So in that case, the transverse vibrations, they produce the transverse vibration, and in this case the frequency formula for frequency we have 1 by 2 L under root T by pi r square d. Now this pi r square d is equal to m, which is known as mass per unit length. So that means in this case, in the case of a string instrument, they produce transverse vibration. First thing, they have a definite natural frequency of their own, and the frequency which is produced in the string, the formula is given by 1 by 2 L under root T by pi r square d, which I told you that is equal to m, which is here m is mass per unit length. So you all know that mass means density is mass per unit volume. So mass will become equal to density into volume, is it? Now here d is your density and pi r square, because we are considering the string in the instrument. So if we'll take a string, it is in the form of cylindrical shape. So the cylindrical volume is pi r square L, is it? Now here you can see that pi r square is given, because L you will take on this side. So that is mass per unit length. So mass per unit length will become equal to pi r square d. So that is why here in place of, in some book it is given under root T by m. So m is not only mass, it is mass per unit length, which will be equal to pi r square d. Clear? Now by this formula we can find out the frequency. But what you can understand from here is that the frequency here depend on the length. F is equal to 1 by 2 L, so that means F is here inversely proportional to length. First thing, F is directly proportional to square root of T, where T is the tension in the string, and F is inversely proportional to square of the radius. R is the radius, so it is inversely proportional to the square of the radius. Okay, so these are the factor on which the frequency depend. Now the frequency of the note can be increased, because these are the frequency depend on these factors. So the frequency can be increased or decreased by changing the length, by changing the radius, by changing the tension in the string. If we'll change that, then the frequency will change. Now the last example that I am going to discuss is again a string of a given length, which is stretched between its end under a given tension, can be made to vibrate in different modes by plucking the string at different points. Clear? So if a string which is stretched between two ends under a given tension, so it can be made to vibrate in different modes by plucking the strings at different points. So as you can see here, in the first case it is plucked at L by 2 length. Okay, so when it is plucked at L by 2 length, so in that case the vibration it will produce is string vibrates in one loop, as you can see. So in that case the vibration is called the principal note of frequency F. Here it is given as F1, the first frequency. Okay, now the first case, Now, if the string is plucked at 1/4 of the length of the string, that means in this case, as I told you, it is plucked at L by 2. Now, if it is plucked at L by 4, so when it is plucked at L by 4, so in that case, it vibrates in 2 loops, as you can see here. And in this case, the frequency will become equal to twice of F1. And similarly, again, if it is plugged at L by 6, then it will vibrates in 3 loop. Clear? So similarly, the frequency we can take it as F1, then 2F1, then 3F1, then 4F1, then 5F1, like that it will go on. Okay? So the different modes of vibration in a stretched string of frequencies are in the ratio 1:2:3. Clear? Now about the wavelength. So the wavelength, if we'll consider, if L is the length of the string which is stretched between the ends, so the wavelength of different modes in the first case, in the second case, in the third case, they will be, in the first case it will be 2L, in the second case it will become 2L by 2, in the third case it will become 2L by 3, and in the ratio form, it will be 3:2:1. Now, there is a formula to find out the wavelength, which is in higher class. In class 11th, you have all that. So, here, this is the case for a string of a given length, which is stretched between its ends under a given tension. Now, the first case, in this case, the frequency, which is known as the principal note, and the second is known as the first subsidiary, and the second one is known as the second subsidiary. Okay, so the first one is known as the principal note of frequency. The second loop in which it vibrates in two loop, this vibration is called the first subsidiary vibration of frequency 2F1. And similarly, if it is plugged at 1/6, then in three loops, so in that case it is called the second subsidiary. Clear? So these are the examples, and not only these 5 examples, there are many examples for natural or free vibrations. Now coming to the damped vibrations. So the periodic vibrations of a body of decreasing amplitude in presence of a resistive force. So the case is here, in case of damped vibration, there is a presence of resistive force. So these vibrations are called damped vibration. Now here are the conditions. In damped vibrations, two forces are present, the restoring force, and second is the frictional force or the resistive force due to the surrounding medium. Second, the amplitude of motion decreases due to the presence of frictional force. Third, now the energy of the vibrating body continuously dissipates in doing work against the friction, and so its amplitude gradually decreases. So as I told you that after certain time, the branch of the tree will stop vibrating. And why it stops vibrating? Because there is a presence of external force, that is the air is providing the resistive force due to which the vibration will stop. So even air is providing the resistive force, so this branch of the tree which is vibrating has to do some external work, has to do some work against this force, and doing the work loses its energy. So due to which the energy of the vibrating body continuously dissipates in doing this work, and it is doing work against the friction, air friction, and so due to which its amplitude will decrease. Clear? That is why in damped vibration, which is actually the case, all the body after a certain time it will stop vibrating. Now, the rate at which the energy is lost to the surrounding medium depends on the nature of the surrounding medium and also on the shape and size of the vibrating body. Now, this is a displacement time graph for your damped vibration. So, as you can see here, now in this case, the amplitude will decrease, and after certain time, it will become completely zero, as you can see by this graph. Clear? So this is the displacement time graph for the damped vibrations. So these are the examples of damped vibrations. As I told you, all the cases what we have discussed, if they occur in natural means atmosphere. So in that case, all are the example of damp vibration. And if they occur in vacuums, all are the example of free vibration. So here you can see in the first example that a boy is holding the branch of a tree. So when he leaves this branch, so obviously the branch will vibrate for some time, and after that it will stop vibrating. So that will be the case for damp vibration. Second is the case of simple pendulum, which is oscillating. So it executes the damp vibration because it occurs in the air present in the atmosphere. Now third is the case of a tuning fork. So in case of a tuning fork, here also when it is stroked on a rubber pad, so it executes the damp vibrations in air. If again here a vacuum is present, so it will vibrate forever, but here it will vibrate and after some time it will stop. So these are the examples of damped vibrations. Now these are the differences. What are the differences between the natural and damp vibrations? So all that we have discussed, just it is a conclusion. If you understand that natural and damp vibration, very easily you can tell the difference between the natural and damp vibration. So first point is the amplitude of natural vibration remains constant and the vibration continues forever. As I told you, in damp vibration the amplitude will decrease with time and ultimately the vibration ceases. Here there is no loss of energy because the vibration will continue forever. There is no opposing force present, so there is no loss of energy. In case of damp vibration, there is a loss of energy in the form of heat. In the case of natural vibration, no external force act on the vibrating body. The vibration are only under the restoring force. In case of damp vibration, in addition of the restoring force, a frictional or a damping force acts on the body, which opposes its motion. Fourth, the frequency of vibration depend on the size and shape of the body and it remains constant. And in this case, the frequency of vibration is less than the natural frequency. The decrease in frequency depend on the damping force. So these are the differences between the natural and damped vibrations. Now coming to the last case, that is the case of forced vibrations. So in case of forced vibration, when we used to say that the vibration will stop after some time. So what if some external force is applied so that the vibration will continue? So such kind of vibration is known as forced vibration. So the vibrations of a body which takes place under the influence of an external periodic force acting on it are called forced vibration. Now in case of forced vibration, there are three forces act. Or present. So these are the restoring force, the frictional or the resistive force, and along with that there is an external periodic force present. Now this external applied force is called the driving force, and here the amplitude of forced vibration depend on the frequency of the external force. So here is an examples of forced vibration. So in case of a guitar, when an artist plays on the string by the finger, the vibration in them cause the forced vibration in the air enclosed in its hollow box. You all have seen the guitar, so you have seen that there is a hollow box present and in that there is a air present. So when they play the guitar, that means when they used to play on its string by their finger, so the vibration in them caused the forced vibration in the air enclosed in its hollow box. Clear? So this is a case for forced vibration. Now second is again a case of vibrating fork. So as I told you that the vibration will stop after some time, but in this case here you can see that when the stem of a vibrating tuning fork is placed on a tabletop, on the top of a table, so in that case the tuning fork produces the forced vibration in the tabletop. Why? Because on the table the area is more. The tuning fork is kept on a table, so here the area is more, so in that case the vibration will be produced with greater energy. Is it? So it will produce a louder sound than produced by the tuning fork. which is not kept on anything. It is directly you try to vibrate this tuning fork. If it is kept on a table, so in that case, because the tabletop, as you can see, has much larger vibrating area, so due to which the force vibration on the tabletop send forth a very large amount of energy and which produces a very large sound. So in this case, the sound produced will be louder than which is produced by a tuning fork which is not kept on anything. Okay, so these are a few examples for forced vibration. Along with this, all the string instruments in which a string is there, which is provided with a hollow sound box, just like in case of a guitar. So strings, they are made to vibrate by plucking, which produces forced vibration in air of the sound box. Since the surface area of air in the sound box is large, because you can see the, if you have seen the guitar, so space is large. So in that case, the force vibration of air send forth a large amount of energy. Because area is more, so it gives a large amount of energy, and due to which it will produce a louder sound. So this is the example for your forced vibrations. Now coming to the differences between the natural and forced vibration, because these kind of questions will be asked, right? Two differences between the natural and forced vibration, or natural and damp vibration. So natural vibration, I hope till now it is very clear to you all. So same points are there. And in case of damp vibration, just compare that. So the vibration of a body in absence of any resistive or external force are called the natural vibrations, and the vibration of a body in a medium in presence of an external, it is written as n, it is an. Okay, the presence of an external periodic force are called forced vibrations. Now the frequency of vibration here depend on the shape and size of the body. Now in this case, the frequency of vibration is equal to the frequency of the applied force. Now here the frequency of vibration remains constant, and here the frequency of vibration changes with the change in the frequency of the applied force. Now last is, the amplitude of vibration remains constant with time. Here the amplitude of vibration depend on the frequency of the applied force. Clear? So this is I think this will become a long lecture, but I hope the this topic is clear to you all, because all that we have to study in combined, that means the forced, natural and the free vibration, so that in the next lecture we'll discuss the resonance in detail. So go through the topic, and if you have any doubt, then you can ask. Thank you.